Alright, ladies and gentlemen, we are hopping into a quick little video on is the Valenti and Easton worth it? So I'm on GC Database Grand Cross Twitter, and this is their original thing. I didn't go over it because there's been so many mistranslations that I just couldn't care about it. So Valenti looked insane. Also, her cosmetics look really cool. Not gonna lie, she actually looked really cool for the first time. I was actually considering summoning, but now I am coming to dip. I'm going to save on my JP account for the anniversary, and I'll be telling you guys why. So originally, she was supposed to increase all allies' pierce rate and crit damage by the value equal to 50% of the hero's crit resistance. So that could have been insane, because if you run her with all triple crit resistance gear, that could have been actually insane. And then run her with like a pierce rate team, Meliodas and Blue Lilia maybe, or just Rugal and Meliodas, that could still be really good. But unfortunately that's not what her passive is. I'll be showing you exactly what it is after. I don't think there's any problem with Easton, I don't believe. I haven't seen anything. It's mainly been the Valenti, because she looked like an absolute god tier unit until the actual translations came out. So yeah, and then this card stayed the same, but three inflicts sever damage equal. Why is this three here? Whatever, inflicts sever damage equal to 300% of attack on all enemies. So it's basically Sariel's card, which is still really good. That's a really good card, and she's a green unit, so she would absolutely slap Goddess Liz. I assume. Granted, maybe her stats are really bad. I don't know. I haven't actually seen her stats. She could be very different than on paper, because remember when that Christmas Elaine dropped? She looked really good. Everyone was like, oh, King Meta's going to be absolutely broken. And then they tried her and she's like, oh, this character is complete trash. So, yeah. And then they have Focus Rocket Punch. They inflict damage equal to 400% of attack on one enemy. And nullify all skill effects, including... Oh, wait. Is this the changed one? Because now it's on one enemy. In the test... Or in the... what they showed was it doing it to all enemies. It showed in the... not trailer, but the live stream, whatever. It showed all enemies. So I guess they got that part right. Inflicts damage equal to 400% of attack on one enemy, nullify all skill effects, including ultimate moves for 2 turns. So you can't cleanse this off, which is really good, but, I mean, so that way King is going to be coming back most likely when she drops. But the bad part is, it was AoE, now it is single target. Granted, it is much more balanced in my opinion, that would be absolutely broken. But now that it's single target, you don't force them to waste a heal, which would make them waste another card, and therefore you'd have a slight advantage, which now you don't have that. Imagine running her with like a King team, which can't use cleanse, bruh. That'd be hilarious. I don't know. Maybe that could have been a good meta. I don't know. But yeah. And so now since it's only on one unit, it's not as effective in my opinion. Oops. Is there another one? Yeah. Okay. Oh, yeah, I should probably go over the ultimate. And then the ultimate is increases damage dealt by 50% and decreased damage taken by 50% for 3 turns. Inflicts damage equal to 350% of attack on all enemies. That is a 1/6, I believe. I think it goes up to 530 or something, 525% for a 6 out of 6. So, I think that ult is really good. It is all enemies, obviously. So, yeah, I think it's very good. And then Easton looks like a more defensive unit to like counteract the one, so you can't really crit. Her unique decreases damage that allies take from single target attacks by 6% for each of the 7 catastrophes. Hero in the team, including sub-slot heroes. Wait, so does that mean the 4th unit, or does that mean the people below them? I assume that means the 4th person. That's what I assume it means. So that is very good, honestly. Like, it's pretty good if you actually have a really good catastrophe team, but I don't really think that many people do. They mainly just have their waifus maxed out, I assume, and then maybe Shin. I wouldn't call him a waifu, but... her other skill is basically, the Lilia. Like, literally almost all these units just have some random ultimate move gauge takeaway. Inflicts damage equal to 450% of attack on one enemy and depletes 3 ultimate move gauge. Oh, this is like Merlin's. Never mind. It looks exactly like Red Merlin's in my opinion, and just gets re-colored pretty much. So nothing to talk about there, but this one is what's really interesting about her. Bubble shower, level three. I think maybe that's what the three is. Level three removes debuffs from all allies, grants debuff immunity, and increases defense related stats by 80% for 3 turns. So you could run her with Tarmiel, which I assume would stack and whatnot, because his attack is based off of defense, which would be absolutely broken. I'm fairly certain. Maybe I'm just looking into this wrong, but it sounds like he could be very broken. But this is basically to make it so you don't crit. Sorry to go back there, but I had to bring that up real quick. Triste Finn. Inflict spike damage equal to 350% of attack on all enemies. Spike 2x crit damage increase. That is the original Easton. This is a new Valenti, by the way. I'm pretty sure it's Mark 2, not Mark 1. And that's why she looks different, I assume. Like, she looks way cooler, in my opinion. But that sucks, because that means I'm fairly certain that the cosmetics don't transfer over. I almost said the UR gear, but no, that does transfer over. But that sucks. But this is the actual version, because I think they did this. Like, what's the difference? Pods are entering battle. I don't know. I'm gonna look at this one. It looks like this is the recent one. Wait. That says all again. I am so sorry. I read that unique for Valencia wrongly. She only buffs herself and not allies. So, yep. Increases all allies. Nope. Only increases her pierce rate and crit damage by the value equal to 50% of the hero's crit resistance, which is why I don't think you should summon on her. Like, yes, she's gonna be very good. Like, I think she could be very good, but I just don't think it could be worth it in the long run, especially for free to plays. I am basically free to play. I wailed a little on the Assault Meliodas banner, and I'm not gonna do it again. The prices on the JP server are disgustingly high, so I will never do it again. But I don't know. I don't think she's worth it at all, honestly, considering I bet you Purgatory Bond is going to be the very next Festival unit that's coming out. I'm calling it right now. In about a month or so, I assume Festival Bond is going to be dropping in March, because that's when Lost Vein dropped. It was like the very last week of March. So I assume it'll probably drop around there. But yeah, my final conclusion is I would not summon on her. You definitely can. If you like the character, go for it. I'm not going to judge you if you summon for a character and you just like the unit. Like, if you summon for Elaine and you like her, go for it. I'm summoning on the one. I mean, at least he's a hype character and he's really good as well. So therefore, it's actually worth my gems. But yeah. Anyways, guys, hope you guys enjoyed this. Hope it brought some foresight to if you should summon or not. And yeah, comment down below who you think is going to be the next banner after this Valenti and Easton. I'm very curious as to what you guys would think. And anyways, guys, hope you guys have a fantastic day, and peace out.